Magandang araw ulit sa inyong lahat. Welcome sa ating channel. Sa pagkakataon na ito ay sasagutan natin ang ating isinagawang self-evaluation under the subject Specialized Crime Investigation. Nasa SE number 84 ito. Okay, so start na natin sa question number 1. Sabi dito, Police Officer Pedro arrives at the crime scene. Being an investigator of the case, what do you think Police Officer Pedro will going to record first? Letter A, time, date of arrival at the crime scene. Letter B, location of the crime scene. Letter C, condition of the weather, direction of wind, and visibility. Or letter D, all made mention should be recorded. Okay, so ang tamang kasagutan is letter D. All made mention should be recorded first. Yan. Okay, let's proceed to question number 2. As a rule, do not touch, alter, or remove anything at the crime scene until letter A, arraignment of the accused, letter B, the evidence has been processed, letter C, the order of the court is handed to the investigator, or letter D, the filing of the case in court. The correct answer here is letter B. The evidence has been processed. Alright? So that is the golden rule. Do not touch or move anything until the evidence has been processed. Ibig sabihin na process na yung crime scene. Okay? Nag-conduct na ng investigation. Natapos na ang sketching. Natapos na rin ang photograph activities sa crime scene. At lahat ng kailangang makuhang ebidensya sa crime scene ay nakuha na lahat. Okay, so that is what we call processing of the crime scene. Let's proceed to question number 3. In large outdoor areas, the police investigator will going to divide the area into strips for searching purposes. The question is, what is the advisable wide per strip? Okay, letter A, 10 feet. Letter B, 8 feet. Letter C, 5 feet. Or letter D, 4 feet. The correct answer here is 4 feet. So that is the advisable area per strip, 4 feet. Alright? So let's proceed to question number 4. Upon arrival at the crime scene, the assailant through inquiry is still in the vicinity. If you are the police officer, what are you going to do? Letter A, shoot the assailant immediately with your gun to prevent him from escaping. Letter B, secure warrant for the arrest of the assailant. Letter C, arrest immediately. Or letter D, congratulate him for job well done. The correct answer here is letter C, arrest immediately. Okay, pwede naman itong arestohin kahit walang warrant kasi papasok ito doon sa tinatawag nating hot pursuit o kaya ito yung pagkakataon na kung saan yung taong arestuin is just has been committed the offense and the arresting officer has a personal knowledge of the fact base sa kanyang inquiry na ang may gawa ng krimen ay yung subject na ito. Kaya valid itong arestuin. Okay? So yung A kasi hindi naman advisable yan. Letter B, that is illogical, or letter D, the more reason. So ang best answer dito, kung best answer ang hanapin natin, is still letter C. Number 5, securing the crime scene is necessary upon arrival. As police officer, what are you going to do? A, installing the crime scene tape or rope. Letter B, make a fence with 10 feet high. Letter C, make a warning sign. Or letter D, designate bystander to prohibit any person to enter the scene if not authorized. Okay, so take note, the correct answer is letter A, install the crime scene tape or rope. Ito yung masigit natin kilala sa police line. Okay, maglagay tayo ng police line ang katawagan natin dyan para hindi makapasok yung mga bystander o kaya yung mga unauthorized person. Yung letter D kasi, designate bystander, bystander should be avoided to participate in the processing of the crime scene. Okay? Kailangan dapat ang magkakaroon ng parte dito sa crime scene ay mga police officers. Number 6, in rooms, buildings, and small outdoor areas, a systematic search of evidence is initiated. What movement technique is recommended for searching the area? A. Sound method. B. Strip method. Letter C. Clockwise method. Or letter D. Wheel method. Okay? So, since that is limited only to a room or building or small outdoor areas, the advisable here is letter C. Clockwise method. Okay? Mula sa gilid, papunta sa gitna. Yan. So that is clockwise method. Number 7, marking the collected evidence is necessary for identification purposes. Which of the following evidence should be marked? Letter A, jewelry. Letter B, pubic hair. Letter C, underwear. Or letter D, knife. Okay? The correct answer is letter D, knife. Okay? Yung jewelry, hindi dapat itong markahan kasi masisira ito, ano? Ang dapat na gawin dito ay tagging, okay? Maglalagay ka ng lobid, okay? Then maglalagay ka ng papel na nakasulat doon yung mga bagay na gusto mong isulat para ma-identify. Yung pubic hair naman, sealing ang the best na gamitin dito, pati na rin yung underwear kasi makokontaminate. Paano mo naman mamarkahan yung pubic hair? Kay sealing, ilagay sa isang transparent envelope o kaya sa plastic container, then lagyan mo ng seal, then doon sa seal niya mismo doon tayo maglalagay ng ating identity. Okay, ganoon din sa underwear kasi kapag underwear, paano mo naman ito mamarkahan, baka magkaroon ng contamination. Okay, so letter D is the correct answer. Number 8, which of the following can tell the point of direction? A. Photography. Letter B, autopsy. Letter C, sketch. Or letter D, image. The correct answer is letter C, sketch. Okay? Meron kasi siyang point of direction, pointing to the north. Yan, yung sketch. Number 9, sketch is considered as a substitute for photograph. A, true. B, false. The answer is false. It is a supplement. Okay? In addition, hindi pwedeng maging substitute. Kasi yung photograph, hindi lahat ng bagay ay nakikita rito. Halimbawa, yung weather condition, yung distance, okay, hindi nakikita sa photograph yan, yung direction, okay, so hindi nakikita sa photograph yan. Kaya yung sketch ang magiging supplement sa photograph. Hindi ito pwedeng maging substitute. Okay, false ang sagot sa number 9. And the last question, number 10. In determining the motive, there are three sources of information. Which of the following is not included? Okay? A. Crime scene. B. Records. C. Friends. Or D. Social media. Of course, kitang-kita, the correct answer there is social media. It is not, this is not, I should say, included as a source of determining information to know the motive of the assailant. Alright, so 10 katanungan ang sinagutan natin sa araw na ito. I-check nyo ang inyong mga papel at bilangin nyo na rin kung ilan ang inyong nakuha. Ang first 5 question, 2 points. Ang last 5 questions naman, 3 points. Okay? Okay, so hanggang dito na lang ang ating vlog sa araw na ito. Maraming salamat. Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat.